Hello, you are watching Phone Arena's video review of the HTC Touch Viva. It's the budget-oriented phone in the Touch series, which are popular for their easy use with fingers. The main reason for this is the Touch 4 interface, which is also present in the Viva. As you can see, the design is quite similar to the one of the HTC Touch and has some nice rounded shapes. We can't say that it looks bad, but this design language has been interesting a year ago, but not anymore. As a whole, however, the Viva is pretty handy and one can easily find enough place for it in a pocket. It is typical for a touchscreen phone to have its screen occupying most of the front. Here it's 2.8 inch with QVGA resolution, but it's concaved, unlike the other touchscreen phones. The colors look good when you're indoors, but once you go out, they quickly get washed away, making it hard to see even what's been written on the screen. Below it, you'll find the D-pad and the Send and End keys. They are comfortable to use, but the main instrument for navigation throughout the menus remain the touchscreen. Other physical buttons include the volume rocker on the left side and the power button on the top. The bottom houses only the mini USB port, which is also used to plug in the headphones. The Viva uses the latest version of Touch 4, which in contrast to the Touch 4 3D, lacks the 3D animations and transitions, taking a bit of its charm away, but on the other hand, it compensates by working really fast. The digital watch from the home tab has been changed with an analog one, which isn't such a great alteration, but we decided that it was worth mentioning. The people tab is with a slightly different appearance. You can store up to 12 contacts in it, as you are able to see only 6 of them, and in order to see the rest, you have to swipe your finger vertically on the screen. If the person you want to call isn't among these 12, you have to tap on All People, which will take you to the classic Windows Mobile phone book. The Viva's multimedia capabilities aren't vast, but we can't say that they are poor either. In order to play videos, you have the standard for this operating system media player. The videos are looking good, but only if their resolution isn't above 320 by 240 pixels, which is also the screen resolution. When the clips are with higher res, the Viva cannot play them smoothly. To listen to music, you can again rely on the Windows media player, but the HTC has also provided the audio manager. It features a nice interface and displays the album covers flawlessly. You can also filter your songs by artist, album, genre, composer or playlist. The sound quality through the speaker is about the average and you don't have the remotest idea what it would be through the headphones, as such are actually missing in the package. And because of the lack of a 3.5 mm jack, we couldn't plug in our favorite headphones. We almost forgot. The YouTube player is also on board, so if you have a good internet connection, you'll be able to enjoy this one too. It's preferable if you use Wi-Fi, because 3G support is also missing. The camera is 2 megapixel and the quality of the pictures is on the average. The good news is that you have multiple settings at least, giving you a chance of trying to get the most of the camera. Same as in other new HTC devices, the browser is based on Opera Mobile 9.5. We praise it a lot and it's definitely worth it. The pages are loading without any problem, even complicated ones like phonearena.com. The Viva's browser also features a rather new element, which we previously saw in the Touch HD, namely the bar for zoom adjustment. It's a nice and useful feature, which gives you additional control over the amount of information that's being displayed. In spite of the various features of the Windows Mobile operating system, it's of major importance how the device performs as a phone. The sound is pretty loud in both directions, but also too sharp. The only cure for this is to turn it down a bit, but in this case you'll need to find a quiet place in order to make a decent conversation without wondering what's being said to you. As a whole, we're pleased with the performance of the device, and despite of its dated hardware, it worked fast, without any lagging or crashing. But let's not forget that in this class, it has a competition in the face of the Eaton X610, which has a GPS receiver, but at the cost of being a bit clumsier. So it seems that your choice depends only on what design and interface type you like the most. Thank you for watching. Please visit phonearena.com for our full review with many pictures and a 360 degree.